about how big a part do your thoughts play in your day-to-day successes of life. I know, that's a little bit of a tongue twister, right? So let me say it again. Have you ever thought about how big of a part do your thoughts play in your day-to-day successes of life? Pastor has begun a series in the month of June entitled, How to Live a Free, Full, Light Life. And this weekend, he talked about bondages and how bondages start in the mind. Now, as you know, we should take away one thing from the message. And the one thing that really just stood out to me this weekend was the bondages that we have in our mind. And how one way to live free, full, and light is to learn how to overcome negative thinking. I heard it said this way, beware of the ants. Automatic negative thinking syndrome. It's pretty good, right? We all have faced it time to time, where we're not careful because the enemy is constantly hurling thoughts at us from the left and the right. And we have to be careful that when we encounter a situation, that our first thought is not thinking negative. I think about the 2016 basketball champions, Cleveland Cavaliers. I think about them being down 3-1, 3-1 in this series. Now, as we all know, those of you that are basketball fans like myself, the Cleveland Cavaliers and the Golden State Warriors played last year, and the Golden State Warriors came out on top. But this time, the series was 3-1 in favor of the Golden State Warriors, and we all thought, okay, the Golden State Warriors are going to take this one. But they didn't. The Cleveland Cavaliers, in my mind, did not have a give-up mentality. They took a 3-1 deficit and turned it around and went on to win the 2016 NBA championship. This excites me. Never give up. When Florence Chadwick decided that she was going to swim some 22 miles from the Catalina shoreline to the California shoreline, the first time she attempted that, she ran into dense fog, gave up, found out that she was only 1 mile from her destination. She decided to try again. Short time later, this time she made it to her destination. The obstacles that had faced her before had faced her again. But this time she didn't give up, she persevered, she had a can-do mentality, and she made it to the other side. I just felt that God was speaking to me. Currently, I'm working on my sophomore project. And of course, even this video blog, obstacles come up day and night. And I think it's easy to give up, and it's harder to stay the course and believe that it can be done. But I believe that if God is giving you a promise, just like the children of Israel, just like Joshua and Caleb, if God has given you a promise, believe that you will see that promise come to pass. Yeah, there may be giants in the land, but I want to encourage you that if thus said the Lord, if he said it, remember, if the Lord says it, believe it,